Let's walk through creating a square cover for Audible for ACX out of your existing Amazon cover. Now, the thing about Audible, if I can share my screen for a second, is that they require your audiobook to be in a square cover. You see all these covers here? They're all in squares. They're not in rectangles like in a Kindle book. And so what we have to do to get our Kindle book online is to do it like this, is to take whatever book cover there is, like if we can try to find it on Amazon. So if we like go to this, let me try Loc Trivedi. So here's this book I've recently narrated. And if we search this book on Amazon, then you can see here that the regular book is a rectangle, and then the audiobook is a square. Now, how do we do it? Well, we use one of my favorite tools ever, which is called Canva, which is a Photoshop replacement. It's in the cloud, doesn't require installation. It's way easier, less things to mess up. And what we'll do is grab the original high resolution cover from Amazon, import it into Canva, resize to be a square. I prefer to do 3000 by 3000 pixels so that way it is large enough, keeping in mind that the bottom right corner, they want it to be clear because sometimes they will place a little special banner there. See how on this Ramit Sethi, there's a banner on the bottom right corner. And those are the things that we need to keep in mind to have it square, keep that bottom corner free. And then also, they don't like to have borders on this square cover. So you see how all of these, even maybe the simplest one is this principles book. There's no like sides where the rectangle was, and then there's a border. It's just a square. So let's do these things. Let's take one of the books that we recently finished, which is this one right here, AI Business Strategies by Bob Pellerin. And we want to grab this book cover and then somehow enlarge it in so that way it fits into a square shape, but it also has that bottom right corner free and does not have borders. So what do we do? Well, first we find the book that we want to turn into an audiobook cover, and we make sure to click over onto the Kindle button. And then I use a tool which I found by searching Kindle High Resolution Cover, and I'll link to it in this video. It's this tool at eReader Palace. You click on it, and they give you lots of unnecessary explanation, which is okay. You scroll down, and what you do is right in here, you paste in the ASIN code. Now, the ASIN code, you go over to the website address, and it's sort of like an ISBN, but it's Amazon's ID number. So we see this is Amazon.com and all this stuff. And then after the DP, there's this special, 12-digit code or so. So we double click it and we right click and copy it, and we copy just that code. Then we place just that code into here. We paste it and then get the cover image. Here we go. So this is the large size cover image that we need to save and then put into Canva, put it in a square shape, and then kind of work our magic and see like, okay, do we need to enlarge what we put in? Do we need to rearrange things? Maybe recreate some of the text. This is where the finesse comes in. So we right click and we save this to our downloads. And then we go over to best tool that there is, canva.com. Click on create a design. And then I'll get out of the way here. We want to click on import file. Then we upload or double click, upload the file, and then use in a new design. Then it asks what size. It's an easy place to get stuck. Just click on custom size and then enter 3000 and 3000 px pixels. This way, this will create a large square for us to play around with. Then it says untitled design. I will name this AI business strategies. That way I know what I'm dealing with. And then we need to probably, my rule of thumb here is I look at the very bottom center and then the right center, and I kind of draw a line and say that Bob Pellerin is going to go right through it. So we'll first try to maybe resize, enlarge this, and see what fits in, and kind of look at this and look at this, because we for sure kind of need it to be almost like way up in here. And so we have a couple of decisions here to make. And by the way, with Canva, you can resize. If you need to crop it, you see how you can kind of just take that out. And sometimes I'll be in a situation where I will need to use one top piece and one bottom piece. And that's where I might go Control C, Control V, and have two copies of this. And I might trim down this part of it and have that piece, and then crop down this other piece. So that might be in handy, right? For us to kind of rearrange the pieces. But for sure, we can't have this Bob Pellerin over onto the right. So I think we might have to do it like this. And if it won't snap to the center, then we can go over to the left ruler and drag this out so that way we can see how we can center that maybe a little bit. So we have a decision here to make, is what do we want this to look like? And I think the way I'm going to cheat a little bit is to try to recreate his name here and make this blue with the purple stripe and then a blue underneath. I think that's what we will do here. So we'll trim this down. And let's think about this for a second. So I like to use a tool called whatthefont.com to identify the font. So we'll say upload an image, and we'll upload that book cover. And then the font we want is, I want that font. Vito, Singularity. I'm not sure if any of these are in here, so we might have to just recreate it. So let me switch back. And then maybe to give us a little bit of progress, let me get the square pieces figured out. So we click on Elements, Shapes, find a square shape. Click on that. And we want the blue and we want the purple. So we click on Color. And then Photo Colors, that gives us the blue. And we'll fill in that bottom part. And then we want another shape. And we click on this. And then from the photo, we want that purple, maybe. And I'm not sure it's exactly right. And so this is where I use a Chrome plugin called Color Pick Eyedropper. I can just click and hover over this purple and get this exact color code, and then click on this color and paste in the purple again. Yeah, see, now we have the correct shade of purple. And we'll try placing this shade of purple right here, but it covered it up. So now we need to go position backward, and that kind of gives us what we want. If we very carefully try to position this in the middle, and I believe that that will be out of the range of what we're trying to do here. I'm concerned that they might not like that very thin border, so we might do a little stretch, and I might do a holding down Alt just to get that border out of the way. So now it goes all the way to the edge. It's square, and we keep the triangle out of the way. And then now I just click on Share and then Download PNG, click on Download, and now Canva, without any Photoshop or anything like that, or even just a little bit of graphic skills, right? We know how to identify the colors, use the color eyedropper for Chrome, do a little resizing, a little trial and error, and then now we have this graphic that, if I go and find where it's saved to in my downloads folder, then this is the graphic that we will then send in to ACX, to Audible, to send to get as an audiobook. And so to recap a little bit, we did a Google search for Kindle higher resolution cover. It took us to this website. We went to the Amazon page for the book that we wanted and then looked very carefully in the URL and grabbed the ASIN ID number, which allowed us to download the graphic. Then we went to this tool, canva.com, said create a design, said import file, and then that allowed us to put it into this square and then do a little bit of guess and check to create the square cover that we wanted. Now, why am I showing you this? Why am I teaching you this? Because my wife and I, Catherine O'Connor, produce and narrate audiobooks. Our website is dfynarration.com. So if you are an author and you are missing out on the new platform opportunity, the platform itself isn't new, but just your access to this library of listeners is new. If you want to be listed on Audible, if you want to tap into a listener audience, not just a reader audience, then contact us. Find us at dfynarration.com. We would love to narrate your existing Kindle book, place it on Audible, and you collect all the royalties. And now that's a new marketplace where you can find buyers and listeners and collect more royalties and just get more reach of your book and your message. Many people don't like to read or they don't have time to read. They'd rather listen to your audiobook on their commute or while driving or while jogging. So get your book on Audible. DFY Narration is the place to get that done. Robert Plank, DFY Narration. Bye for now.